Hello students, in this session we will see an introduction to a concept, functional dependency. Actually in the previous session we have studied some guidelines which are used to design a relational schema. This is a continuation of the previous session. Here functional dependency is a tool which we are using to ensure the quality of a relational schema which is already designed. So in the previous class we have studied what are the things you have to remember when designing a schema. Now we are studying a tool or a measure which is used to analyze the quality of an already designed relational schema. So introduction to functional dependency. It's a formal tool to analyze a relational schema or to analyze the quality of a relational schema. Actually, it's a constraint or a condition between two sets of attributes in a database. Now, the definition of functional dependency is given. In the definition, the representation is shown. This is how functional dependency is represented. It's denoted by X to Y between two sets of attributes X and Y that are the subsets of R. R is a common relational schema or universal relational schema, specifies a constraint on the possible tuples that can form a relational state R of capital R. Now, the constraint is that for any two tuples T1 and T2 that have T1 of X equal to T2 of X, they must also have T1 of Y equal to T2 of Y. So this is a formal definition of functional dependency. The meaning is only this, that is, if you consider X and Y are two sets of attributes of a relational schema, then for any two tuples T1 and T2, if T1 of X equal to T2 of X, then T1 of Y also will be same as T2 of Y. That is, if the value of X is repeated for any two tuples T1 and T2, then value of Y also will be repeated for T1 and T2. That is the meaning of functional dependency. So simply we can say if X is repeated, then Y also will be repeated. That property is called a functional dependency from X to Y, where X and Y are two sets of attributes. So this means that the values of Y depended on X. That is, if X repeats, Y also will be repeated. Now this is a notation for functional dependency. It represents a functional dependency from X to Y, or we can say Y is functionally dependent on X. Here I have already told you X is a set of attributes and Y is another set of attributes. So the set of attributes in X is called the left hand side of FD, that is left hand side of functional dependency, where the attributes in Y are called right hand side of the functional dependency. We will see one example. Consider a schema employ with attributes name, SSN, address and license number. Here we have already defined a set of functional dependency exist in the schema. The first functional dependency defined as a dependency from SSN to name. So in the X to Y notation, here SSN is the left hand side and the name is the right hand side of the functional dependency. So what is the meaning? SSN to name is a functional dependency. That is, whenever SSN repeats, name also will be repeated. We know that is true because SSN will be unique for a particular tuple. So no two tuples will have the same SSN, or no two employees will have the same SSN. So whenever SSN is repeated, name also must be repeated. So we can define a functional dependency from SSN to name, or we can say name is functionally dependent on SSN. Similarly, the next FD is from SSN to name, address and license number. That is, whenever SSN is repeated, in that tuple name, address and license number will be repeated. Again, Another functional dependency is license number. We know that also will be unique for a particular person. So no two employees will have the same license number. So whenever license number is repeated, all the other details will be automatically repeated. That is defined here. There is a functional dependency exists from license number to SSN name and address. So this is the concept of functional dependencies exist in a schema. Now we will see some properties of functional dependency. If X is a candidate key of R, that is, if X is a candidate key, means it will be unique. This implies that X to Y for any subset of attributes Y in R. That is, if X is a candidate key of R or X is a primary key of R, definitely X to Y exist for every Y where Y is a subset of attributes of R. The same concept we have seen in the example. Here SSN is a candidate key, that is, it is one of the unique attribute that is called a candidate key. So if SSN is a candidate key, then there exists a functional dependency from the candidate key to any subset of attributes in that schema. Then second property is, if X to Y in R, that doesn't mean that Y to X exists. So what is the meaning? A dependency from X to Y does not mean that Y to X also exists. Example is shown. SSN to name will be always true. That is, whenever SSN repeated, name will be repeated. But the reverse is not true. Whenever name repeated, SSN will not be repeated. So a functional dependency from X to Y is not same as Y to X. Now this is a diagrammatic representation of functional dependency. We are considering this functional dependency from SSN to address, name and license number. So here the schema is shown, name, SSN and address, license number. These are the attributes. First functional dependency is numbered as FD1 here. The left hand side is SSN here. That is denoted by this line. Then all the attributes in the right hand side are joined with arrowed lines. So this is how functional dependency is diagrammatically represented. Like this, the second functional dependency from SSN to name is represented here. From SSN to name is a dependency. So this is how it should be represented. Like this, all the functional dependencies in the same schema will be represented within the same diagram itself. Now we will continue with properties of functional dependency. First property is trivial functional dependency. A functional dependency is trivial if it is satisfied by all relations. So it will be true for all relations. Then it is called a trivial functional dependency. Example, a dependency from X to X. So what is the meaning? If X is repeated, X is repeated. So that is a trivial functional dependency. Or we can say a functional dependency from X to Y is trivial if Y is either subset of X or same as X. An example is shown here. Here from SSN to name, then to SSN. So whenever SSN and name is repeated, SSN will be repeated. Here Y is a subset of X. So this will be true for all relations. Such functional dependencies are called a trivial functional dependency. Then another concept is closure of a functional dependency. Actually, closure is a set of all functional dependencies denoted by F+, which can be inferred from a given set of functional dependencies F. So that is a formal definition of closure of functional dependency. Here a set of functional dependencies can be defined for a relation schema. From the already defined dependencies, we can derive some more functional dependencies. So closure is a set of all functional dependencies which are already defined and which can be derived from already defined dependencies. So we can say closure set is a superset of defined functional dependencies. So closure includes already defined dependencies along with that the dependencies which we can derive from the given ones. So that's what it is written. Hence F plus can be considered as a superset of F. So it's a superset of or universal set of all functional dependencies. So that's all about an introduction to functional dependency. In the next session, we will see how closure set can be derived from an existing set of functional dependency. So there are certain rules to derive functional dependencies that we have to study in detail in the next session. So all of you go through this session clearly and study the concept, then only you can follow the next session. Thank you.